जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19। India saw a slight dip in the number of daily coronavirus disease cases after recording nearly 40,000 infections for 2 days in a row. There were 37,148 fresh COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours after a tally of 38,902 infections on Sunday and 40,425 patients on Monday. There are 4,02,529 active cases of the coronavirus disease across the country as of Tuesday morning. More than 7 lakh patients have been cured of COVID-19 and discharged until now. The NCERT has revised a chapter in its Class 12 Political Science textbook to drop a paragraph on separatist politics in Jammu and Kashmir and to add a brief mention of scrapping of its special status last year. The National Council of Education Research and Training has revised the chapter in the textbook Politics in India Since Independence for the academic session 2020-21. While the topic Separatism and Beyond has been deleted from the chapter, the scrapping of Article 370, which gave the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir special status, has been included under the topic Regional Aspiration. Amid protest by opposition parties and local residents against the BJP-led NDA government at the centre, the National Highway Authority of India made Lakhanpur Toll Plaza in Kathua district operational from Tuesday morning. The toll plaza was inaugurated by Ajay Kumar Rajak, Project Director Jammu NHAI, who claimed that the toll plaza was supposed to be made operational in 2012 when the four-laning of Jammu-Pathankot Highway was completed. This is the fourth toll post in Jammu region. An army personnel was injured in a landmine blast in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri district on Tuesday. During patrolling duty, the army man stepped on a landmine resulting in the blast along the LOC in Kaka Forward area of Noshera sector. The army personnel has been hospitalized. Three persons, including a couple, were killed after lightning struck them at Gumsar area of Punch district in Jammu division early on Tuesday. The deceased have been identified as Mohammad Hasik of Lathong village in Surankot, his wife Zarina Kosar and Javed Ahmed of Lasana Top. Shari Mubarak, the holy silver mace of Lord Shiva, was taken to ancient Sharika Bhavani temple in the downtown Srinagar on Tuesday to pay obeisance to goddess as per the age-old traditions associated with the annual pilgrimage to Amarnath Cave Shrine in South Kashmir Himalayas. However, only a selected number of sadhus participated in pujan that lasted for more than an hour in view of the COVID-19 pandemic. On Monday, similar traditional pujan associated with the yatra was held at Shankaracharya Temple in Srinagar. Amid the ongoing boundary dispute between India and China, DRDO has provided its indigenously developed drone named Bharat to the Indian Army for carrying out accurate surveillance in high-altitude areas and mountainous terrain along the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh. The Bharat series of the drones can be listed among world's most agile and lightest surveillance drone, indigenously developed by the DRDO. With the target of providing protection to the local residents from shelling during the unprovoked ceasefire violations by Pakistan, the construction of underground community bunkers has started at villages along the line of control in Uri in the Baramulla district. Each community bunker will be constructed at an estimated cost of Rs 10 lakh each. It will comprise of 2 rooms besides a washroom. In an attempt to increase awareness about coronavirus precautions and urge readers to wear face masks, Roshni, a local Urdu daily in Srinagar, gave its readers a free face mask. In a pleasant surprise for readers, the mask was pasted on the front page of the newspaper with subtext saying using masks is important. Many took to social media to appreciate the move by the publisher. peeved over the exclusion of candidates having qualification above 10+2 from participating in 8,575 Class 4 recruitments, the activist of NPP led by Harshdev Singh, chairman JKNPP, and former minister held a thunderous protest demonstration and torched the effigy of the BJP government. Speaking on the occasion, Harshdev Singh accused the BJP government of betraying the educated youth, which negligible job avenues have been created during the past 6 years of saffron rule. The number of COVID-19 deaths per million population in India continues to be amongst the lowest in the world, Rajesh Bhushan, officer on special duty, Health Ministry, said on Tuesday. Some countries are reporting 12 to 13 times cases per million population as compared to India. He said that 30 states and union territories have a positivity rate lower than India average.
को देखें per million population के हिसाब से तो ये 20.4 है भारत में. ये भी विश्व में सबसे कम मृत्यु दरों में से है.
जम्मू एंड कश्मीर अपनी पार्टी प्रेसिडेंट सैयद मोहम्मद अल्ताफ बुखारी ऑन ट्यूसडे अप्ड द एंटी फॉर रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ स्टेटहुड टू जेएंडके दैट वाज डिसमेंटल्ड साइमल्टेनियसली विद द स्क्रैपिंग ऑफ इट्स स्पेशल स्टेटस ऑन सेइंग दैट इट इज नेसेसरी टू ओवरकम द सिमरिंग पॉलिटिकल डिसएंगेजमेंट प्रेवलेंट अमंग द पीपल. This call for the restoration of the statehood has been amplified by the Apni Party chief to reassert that there could be no compromise on the restoration of the statehood to J&K, even when his party is reluctantly reconciling to the loss of special status as a new reality but wants J&K and its people to be treated at par with the people in the rest of the country.